there's been, I think, a sense of complacency that we were lulled into in January, February. COVID's over. Doesn't matter. Vaccination's coming. Doesn't matter. Even if you get COVID, what's the big deal? You know, it's not that fatal. Not that many people die about it. You will not fall that seriously ill. Both of you, in a sense, are at ground zero. So if I could just ask you to tell us, what is it that you are seeing at ground zero? Professor Malhotra, why don't I start with you at the, at the COVID trauma center at AIIMS? What is it that you're seeing? What is the sort of pressure that is coming?
Yeah, thanks, Vikram. I think we are, like you said, we are feeling as you would feel in the midst of a tsunami. Like you said, there has been an infection more dreadful than COVID, and that has been the infection of indifference. And like you said, people have just stopped caring. And now suddenly, you know, the pressure on us is not just because of the COVID cases, but then there are cases who have had COVID before, a small percentage, maybe 5% are those who are coming, who have previously had COVID and are also turning positive. And we are also having a group of patients who had recovered from COVID and now are getting super-added infections on the damage caused on the lungs by the previous infection. So the pressure on the hospital is tremendous. Of course, the number of people affected are younger, but then having said that, we are getting more younger people to hospital in a serious state than we were in the previous go. And the comorbidities, again, they are galore. So I think this is a situation nobody would like to be in. We are really inundated. The hospitals are just overflowing. It's actually really a very, very worrisome situation.
Okay, Dr. Soyen, I think we're hearing from AIIMS out there the sense of complacency. I've been seeing you tweeting, and we've often, you know, that sort of pressure. Tell us about it. How bad is it on the ground? Because maybe people need to wake up a little bit.
Well, the situation here at Medanta, and I'm sure all other hospitals, Vikram, is exactly as grim as Rajesh has just pointed out. We are absolutely flooded with patients. We actually having to open new wards and ICUs literally every two or three days. We have nearly 300 patients now. It's a myth that people are not falling sick or becoming critical anymore. Unfortunately, the proportion of patients who are in the ward and who are in the ICU or getting ventilated and unfortunately even dying remains the same as last year. So we are actually in the midst of a really, really worrisome second wave of COVID, which has grown much faster. The numbers, as you know, are double of what they were at its peak last year. And also, a lot of younger people are coming into hospital. That's true. In fact, my physicians tell me that this time around, the patients are getting many more GI symptoms. They're getting the snuffles, the cold, and the sneezing much more than they did last year. These were not very typical symptoms last year. And a lot of patients are complaining of high fever for a long time, like for a week or 10 days this time around. There are many people who've had vaccination who are also getting infected, but luckily those people are not having severe disease at all. So overall, pretty grim. And I think this is spiraling out of control.